Hello, everybody, and welcome to another Weather Minds at Home selection. Today, we get to talk about wind chill, something that we will be talking more about in the months ahead as winter approaches. And we're going to talk about exactly what wind chill is and why it makes us feel so cold. First, let's talk about the human body. The typical human produces temperatures, a core temperature about 98.6 degrees, and that creates a layer of warmth that helps keep us warm, especially during the winter months. But as the wind starts to pick up, we sort of lose that layer of warmth. The body temperature drops faster. Wind whisks away that layer of warmth, helping it feel noticeably colder. Also going on exposed skin, we have this thin layer of moisture. Even if you're not sweating, we still have this thin layer of moisture. And as the wind encounters that exposed skin, the wind evaporates that moisture, and that's actually a cooling mechanism that helps it cool the air immediately around your skin and helps you feel even colder. We have to thank this process in the summertime because it helps us feel cooler. As we sweat, it whisks away water. The evaporation cools our skin, but in the winter months when the conditions are right, that evaporation closer to our skin can actually be dangerous for us. If the wind chill is cold enough, it could also lead to some frostbite. So of course, something that we'll be talking more about in the months ahead as we get closer to winter.
Hi everyone, I'm Kara Levin, meteorologist Laura Betker, and today's book is The Magic School Bus in the Arctic, a book about heat. Ms. Frizzle is the weirdest teacher in school. Strange things always seem to happen in her class, but it had gotten to be so cold outside, not even Ms. Frizzle could do anything too unusual, or so we thought. It all started in the cafeteria when Arnold ordered a steaming cup of hot cocoa with marshmallows. By the time he took his first sip, the heat had escaped out an open window. Arnold was left with yucky, cold cocoa. "Where did all the hot go?" he asked. That's when Ms. Frizzle got that snowy sparkle in her eyes. The next thing we knew, we were on the magic school bus, but now it had skis and tractor treads instead of tires. We were traveling through one of the coldest places on Earth, the Arctic, and we didn't even have our coats on. Ms. Frizzle pressed a button and jackets dropped from the top of the bus, but they were too thin to keep us warm, and while the Frizz was searching for the warm jacket button, she drove the bus into deep ice-cold water. When we got to the other side, the bus was dripping with ice and the engine was frozen. Then the bus just stopped, and we were stuck in the Arctic. We had to figure out a way to warm up the bus and get back home. We were cold, but poor Liz was freezing. Liz is cold-blooded. She gets most of her heat from outside her body, explained Phoebe as she tucked Liz inside her jacket. "Don't worry, Liz," she said. "I'm warm-blooded. My heat is your heat." Just then, Wanda pulled out an old wooden trunk from under a seat. Inside, we found a bunch of goggles. Ms. Frizzle said they were heat peepers. It was amazing. When we put them on, we could actually see heat moving out of our bodies. "Moving heat must mean losing heat," said Phoebe. We could see the heat escaping right out of the top of the bus. The heat was escaping fast. We needed a heat source. Luckily, Arnold found some wood inside the old trunk. In no time, a fire was burning and Ms. Frizzle was cheerfully brewing hot lemon water tea. Ms. Frizzle poured tea into a hot water bottle. With our heat peepers, we could see the heat going into it. Carlos tucked the bottle inside his jacket. He felt warmer right away. Arnold looked at the other hot water bottles on the ground. "What if we cover the engine of the bus with hot water bottles?" he suggested. "The heat from the bottles will move into the engine. The engine will warm up, the bus will start, and we can go home." It was a good idea, but it was too late. Just then, the ice we were standing on cracked into pieces. The bus floated away, and so did Ralphie and Phoebe and Liz. We had to save Ralphie and Phoebe, but we were freezing. "Look," said Carlos, "the heat from my hot water bottle is almost gone. We have to find something else to keep ourselves warm." Arnold said he looked at Dorothy Ann's book. "We could use that." Arnold started to rip out pages from a book and stuff them inside his jacket. I hate to hurt a book, but this is an emergency. Putting this paper between us and the cold air might keep the heat from escaping, Arnold explained. The paper did slow down the loss of heat a little bit. Ms. Frizzle said the paper was acting like insulation. It was holding in heat. But we still needed a better heat source if we were going to save the bus and get home. There's a fur coat and a heat source due north of here, said the Frizz. Follow me. Ms. Frizzle was right. The heat source was warm, furry, and smelled like fish. Suddenly, we got it. This was no ordinary heat source. This was a polar bear. Run, said Carlos. Hide, said Tim. Oh, bad, oh, bad, oh, bad, said Keisha. Ms. Frizzle came to the rescue. She whipped out the portashrinker and zap, we were as small as a bee's knees. We whirled into the bear's fur. We were tiny but warm. We could see the heat coming out of the polar bear's body and getting trapped by his thick, tangled fur. The fur kept in the heat, just like the paper under our jackets kept in our body heat. Suddenly, our polar bear got itchy. We tried to hang on, but we couldn't. It was time to make tracks. Back on the bus, Phoebe and Ralphie were pretty cold. Phoebe searched the bus for blankets, but when she reached inside the blanket compartment, she came out with a handful of gloopy blubber. What kind of blanket is this? Asked Phoebe. It's a fat blanket, said Ralphie, looking through his heat peepers, and it sure can keep in the heat. Suddenly, the bus tipped dangerously. Ralphie and Phoebe looked out and saw walruses trying to climb onto the ice floe. Is it just me, or are those walruses floating in freezing cold water without losing much body heat? Phoebe asked. And they don't have thick fur like polar bears. I bet all that blubber in their bodies traps their heat, just like the fat on your hand, Ralphie said. If it's good enough for a walrus, it's good enough for us, said Phoebe. Then she and Ralphie covered themselves from head to toe in gloopy fat. But Phoebe and Ralphie weren't out of ice-cold water yet. If their floe was breaking apart and we couldn't reach them. We have to save them, said Keisha. But we won't last in that icy water, said Dorothy Ann. Never fear, said the Frizz. Where there's a Liz, there's a way. She gave a whistle, then called out, hit it, Liz. Liz ran into the bus and pulled a lever on the dashboard. Suddenly, the roof of the bus opened and something came flying across the water right at us. We swam for the bus. We felt warm in our blubber suits. We were glad to be back together, but we still had to find a way to warm up the bus so we could get back home. We tried exercising. The heat escaping from our bodies melted the fat and warmed up the bus for a while. Then the heat escaped out the top of the bus. We need something to trap the heat and keep it inside, Arnold said. Luckily, the bus had special igloo building equipment, so we built an igloo around the bus to trap escaping heat. Ms. Frizzle explained that the snow on the igloo can trap heat because snow is filled with tiny air pockets. The heat moves into these air pockets and gets blocked. As soon as our igloo was built, we went back to exercising. It was a big workout. The heat from our bodies was kept inside the igloo, so the bus started to warm up. Before you could say jumping jack, the engine was ready to go and we put the blubber to the road. We were just in time. Ms. Frizzle turned the bus into a helicopter and got us out of there just before the ice floe broke into tiny pieces. Back at home, Arnold ordered another nice mug of hot cocoa, but this time he wasn't going to let the heat escape. He wrapped up his drink in a homemade double-layer zipper-lidded quilted cocoa cozy. Well, as Ms. Frizzle always says, the inspiration of insulation. And here's an experiment that you all can do at home today with a little help from an adult. Here's how to do it. Choose several different materials. Here's some suggestions. Cotton, a pillowcase, a sleeping bag, tin foil, or paper. What are your ideas? Make a prediction. Which material do you think will insulate best or second best? Write down your guesses. Now ask an adult to help you toast some bread. Toast one slice for each material you're testing. When the toast is ready, quickly wrap each slice inside one of the insulators. Keep each piece of insulated toast in the same place and wait 3 minutes. Now unwrap the toast and touch each slice. Which slice feels the warmest? Was your prediction correct? If you can, try this experiment again to see if you get the same result. Write down what happens each time.